Oh no,
what happened?
Their module went away. So it's only in 30-minute increments.
We should have walked and hit
the hit. But at least we'll get another Pokestop to show you. Have you used Allure yet for yourself?
I have not, no.
Okay, when we get to this next Pokestop, we're gonna go into your items, see what you have.
Sure.
You probably have a lot of Pokeballs, I would imagine.
Stop it, thank you. Yeah. And, there's another
Drowsy up here. I told you, so many freaking Drowsies.
Should we?
Oh, now he's gone.
Now he's, we waited.
Yeah.
I guess, oh, there's another guy. Is it duck?
A Psyduck.
Oh, cool. Here we go.
So if you wait until, you got that one, but if you wait until the circle in the center is smaller, it's actually easier to catch. Yeah, so you get more XP too if you throw a curveball. That's a little bit more advanced.
Okay.
We'll cover it in another video. Okay, so we're in range of this Pokestop.
Okay. I think we could
got some Pokeballs.
The Swan Lake mural.
Yes. You don't. You also, fun fact, you don't have to press every single item that you get. If you just X out, it brings them all into your, your inventory.
I've been doing this for the past 3 days. Okay, cool.
After a while, you just want to
do the
bare minimum.
Absolutely.
To get the most. Yeah. We're going to go into your items.
Items.
So right now, you have some potions and revives, which is great. Potions and revives are great when you start battling in gyms. You have incense right now, which is something that attracts
other Pokemon.
So it's just for you though.
Cool.
Like other people can't reap the benefits from that.
Sure.
But yeah, you'll get a lot more Pokemon as long as that's going on 30 minutes long. So something that you can buy more of if you want to spend money on the actual game, you can get more incubators. You can increase the level of your backpack so you can have more stuff in your inventory. Yeah, you can increase the number of Pokemon you're allowed to keep if that's something you want to do. And then you can also get the coins from battling in gyms, but you don't get them as fast.
Oh, okay.
And I'm impatient.
Have you found, the Pokemon that live in the water, are they more by the rivers and stuff? Or?
I have noticed. I don't know if you played the game outside of Stamford, but if you go into, I work in Manhattan as well at SiriusXM, and so in that building, there are a ton of different kinds of Pokemon. It's really cool in, more densely populated areas because people are more likely to throw lures out.
Okay.
And then, moving around, when you go to different cities. I went to LA, completely different Pokemon out there.
You gotta be kidding me.
World changed. Yeah, I think I got my Ekans in LA, a Meowth.
I remember that guy.
In Manhattan, there are so many Magmites.
My friend had he was the guy that kind of did this and his tongue was out. Called, but yeah.
Can you do the impression?
It's hard to talk with the tongue out, but that, I don't know what it was called.
How do you do it?
It was like that. It was I don't know what it's called. You said a lick a tongue maybe?
Maybe.
I'm going to regret doing that soon. But yeah, basically, that's what it was.
Please show all of those things.
Have you found anything crazy in the Stamford area?
Not really.
Okay. Yeah, so I guess Stamford is not the hotbed for Pokemon it would be, yeah.
I think the highlight of Pokemon Go was finding out that there was a gym in HQ.
Oh, no way,
which I've heard Sean has taken over.
I go to the gym, once in a year or so, and the one time I go, I went crazy.
I feel like it changes up so much. So I went to capture the gym.
Yeah.
And I did successfully a week and a half ago.
Nice.
And within 20 minutes, I saw two kids just roll up and they were walking past HQ.
Really?
And they just they got the gym in 2 seconds.
Whoever wins the battle, they kind of control the gym. Is that how it goes?
So it depends on what level the gym is at.
Okay.
If it's a higher gym, it'll take longer, more battles to claim that gym.
Sure.
But if it's a gym and there's one Pokemon in it and
it's not that great,
you're gonna get the gym pretty fast.
I think there's actually a gym in my apartment building. I should check that one out for multiple reasons. Work out as well maybe. But so the first few times I played this game, literally my phone battery was not doing too well.
Yeah.
And then by the end of it, it was almost dead. So I had to put it down for a bit. But today I charged it. I have my charging case as well in case we play it for a while. So I'm good to go.
It eats up a lot.
Yeah.
Of battery.
It eats up battery like I eat M&M's, so it's pretty crazy.
Do you know the power saving mode?
I don't know.
Okay, this is very important. If you don't know the power saving mode, what you can do is you go into settings.
Okay.
Just hit battery saver.
Okay.
So if you turn that on,
okay.
You can walk around and you'll still get the vibration or whatever notification that a Pokemon's around.
Yeah.
It doesn't tell you if there's a Pokestop around,
okay.
but it is a way to not eat up your entire battery by playing Pokemon.
And still play the game.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good to know. In New York, you said you found the guy with the magnets on his head?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
I think it's cool that they kind of tailor them to whatever city.
Okay.
Like, having the Rattatats in New York City is just really funny to me for some reason. Do you have a Jinx?
Probably not, but let's see. I have a Zubat. I have a Squirtle.
Yes.
I have a Rattatat.
Rattatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatat because he's Jamie Lannister, because he has no hands. Yeah. Okay, so I think this is actually a Pokestop.
Okay.
Right?
It is now. Okay, this
This is Frozen beautiful Forest. Electrical box, yeah. Which is...
It's buzzing, which
kind of
scares me.
All of the electrical boxes around Stanford seem to be painted and also seem to be Pokestops.
There we go. I did the X out. I got I got an egg.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. So...
Oh, to look at eggs, you have to go into Pokemon, not items. Yeah.
Oh, now I have two eggs. All right, well, I'm not going to get too excited. They're 2 kilometer ones.
Yeah.
Start incubation.
No, you don't have, you only have one incubator, so you have to go.
Oh, wait, so that one's all good. Yeah. Okay, that's cool.
Or you can buy another incubator, but I wouldn't recommend
I'll wait.
That.
You know, I'll get to 10 right kilometers at some point
especially,
this month. Yeah.
So that's the other thing that I recommend is when you buy an incubator, you have 3 uses.
Wow.
And so you don't want to use that on a lower kilometer egg because then you get less uses out of it.
Okay.
So if I do buy an incubator, I want to save that for like the 5km or the 10km eggs.
And eventually I will be able to, the eggs will hatch without me incubating them?
No.
Okay, well, you know, down the road we'll get there. 1 kilometer at a time.
Wow.
Brown pants and all, let's do it, baby. I hit him. Oh, come on. Perfect.
There you go.
Okay.
I might just do a regular Pokeball because I don't want to risk it.
You got it? Nice.
Yes.
Perfect.
I'm going to transfer that.
Yeah. I'm going to let this guy hang out for a bit. Oh, wow.
Have I showed you how to transfer yet?
No, I don't think so.
Because I'm going to transfer this guy.
Okay.
I don't really want him because I have so many. Okay, so what you do is you scroll down.
Sure.
It tells you where you found it, what day you caught it on.
Okay.
Transfer him.
Yeah.
And then you get a candy.
Okay.
So what you can do, I don't have enough drowsy candies right now.
Sure.
But eventually, that's how you evolve these guys. So if I had 50 drowsy candies, I could evolve this guy into a Hypno.
A Hypno? Is that like the drowsy's like
this is
evolved
a Hypno
form?
Yeah.
Oh, he lost that's weight and everything.
Like.
Yeah, nice.
No baby fat anymore.
No, that's a real growing up Pokemon, Hoder.
Very good at holding doors.
Nice. So I guess the Psyduck I got was 132. That's pretty good.
Okay, so another thing that you can do is we're going to look by combat power and see. These are your top Pokemon. So when you're battling, your top 6 will be allowed in the gym.
I can't imagine these guys fighting. They look so nice.
Psyduck, right?
Yeah.
Are you a pacifist Pokemon Go player?
I just
don't want
to
battle?
I like to make friends with everyone, you know? Like, what's Psyduck going to do? Like, he has like a fighting power?
Yeah, so what you can do is you see... all of their abilities. So Aqua Tail is going to be his best one.
Okay.
But you have to use the Zen Headbutt several times until you can get there. So like with Hodor's, there's Confusion, which will do a little bit of attack.
Okay.
And then there's a Shadow Ball. So you have to do a bunch of Confusion first, and then I can unleash a Shadow Ball attack, and that's gonna have more of an impact.
Okay. So you kind of have like almost like a move that sets up another move.
Yeah.
Okay. Have you been in many battles yet?
I don't do that many just because there are no gyms really by me. There's like one, but it's in a church and I feel weird.
Yeah, I know. You walk in, Father, I've come here to battle Pokemon. Yeah, for me it would be a rabbi. I'm here to fight some Pokemon. Shabbat shalom. Yeah. So I guess coming up next we have, it looks like there's stuff in the gym, in our gym. So that means that there's a Charizard in the gym at headquarters right now?
Oh, well, actually... Even though we're still too far away from it, you can see what Pokemon are in that place. So is it worth going there? There's a Snorlax.
Oh, jeez.
Flareon, Dragonite.
Dragonite. Should we head towards there and see what else we find?